running as fast as his little legs could take him, at long last, Memphis, back in his mother's arms. For 8 agonising weeks, he's been longing for his mum's kisses and hugs. Today, they were finally reunited.
We are so, so excited to get him home.
It was a mighty mission, the 3-year-old leaving his grandparents' cattle station near Griffiths this morning, homeward bound on an Angel flight plane.
He's been up since 3. He knows something's going on.
His mum flying from Harvey Bay to meet him in Brisbane, then the nervous wait at Archerfield Airport while he was up in the air.
He's very excited to be coming home.
It's a reunion they feared wouldn't happen so soon. Memphis went to visit his grandparents on July 9, and when Queensland's border slammed shut with just 12 hours' notice, there wasn't enough time to make the 14-hour trip interstate. His mum repeatedly tried to get an exemption but was knocked back until yesterday.
We requested over the phone, my mother, myself.
This is not only about Memphis. This is about everyone that is having this problem.
Thousands more still trying to apply for an exemption are confused about the process. Taking to Facebook, you cannot see any updates on the online application. They don't want to provide anything in writing.
Extremely frustrating, yeah. Extremely frustrating.
The government says it's trying to simplify the process.
We've been working very hard over the last week, police and health.
Pilot Paul Michelle volunteered his time for today's 9-hour Mercy Dash.
They're always very, very grateful. So it is good to see.
Well, Memphis is back on home soil. He won't be leaving anytime soon. He and his family will have to isolate on their property for the next 2 weeks under strict Queensland health orders.
This afternoon, he landed back in Harvey Bay and back with his dad.
This is the best Father's Day present ever.
And back doing what 3-year-olds do best.
He's got the chooks to chase around. He's got so much to do. So it'll be great. 14 days of just the 4 of us, which is so good.
Time together after so long apart. Samantha Heathwood, 7 News.